Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Amma ba'da, habita fillah, as a reminder to myself and my brothers and sisters, when we get distracted in the dunya, when we begin to think about other things and we forget about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the importance of reminding ourselves constantly to make dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is why a dhikr tanfa al-mu'mineen, that remembering, the remembrance and bringing people to remembrance. And this is the importance of da'wah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that it will benefit the believer. That'll benefit the believer, the one who already has iman, but perhaps they're distracted, perhaps they've forgotten, and they need a reminder of that which they already knew. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Kitabi al-Kareem, and this ayah here is dalil, it's evidence for the rububiyatillah. It is evidence for the lordship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this we refer to as Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. This is adilla or evidence for the category of Tawheed, which is the concept of Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. Tawheed, the monotheism, which deals with the lordship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything, that He provides for everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qala Allahu ta'ala fi kitabi al-kareem, Qul, من يرزقكم من السماء والأرض أمن يملك السمع والأبصار ومن يخرج الحي من الميت ويخرج الميت من الحي ومن يدبر الأمر فسيقولون الله فقل أفلا تتقون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Kitab al-Kareem, and this is in a way of for the da'i to present argumentation, to bring a pure argument, a pure, pristine, strong point to those who disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and those who commit shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by saying, Qul, say, who provides for you from the heavens and earth? Min as-sama'i wal-ard. And who is the one who possesses the hearing and sight, and who brings about life from death and brings about death, brings about death from life, and who is the one who controls all the affairs and plans all the affairs? They will say, meaning the mushrikeen, they would say, and this is the argumentation for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to give to the mushrikeen, and this likewise is the da'wah for us, that they will then say, because they will reply, they will say, فَسَيُقُولُونَ اللَّهِ, it's Allah. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is ordered, then he said, therefore say, أَفَلَا تَتَقُونَ, then why don't you fear Him? So when we're talking about fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah, it's talking about worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, devoting all of your, directing all of your ibadah to Allah azza wa jal, to not worship with anyone, to ascribe anyone to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not the Prophet Jesus alayhi salatu wasalam, not the Prophet Moses alayhi salatu wasalam, not Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, all the way to Adam, the father of mankind alayhi salatu wasalam, wala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. No one possesses divinity, only the one who created all of them. And He is the one who planned everything. And He is the one who created everything. And He is the one who brings about, He resurrects life from the dead. And this will happen in the hereafter. And He will bring about from those who are living, all of us shall die. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is His sunnah qawniyah. He has created this. He has decreed this for us. All of us shall taste death. Kullu nafsin dha'ikatul maut. Every soul shall taste death. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who created all of this, and it is in accordance with his divine decree. So therefore, at the end of the ayat, and this is in Surah Yunus, verse 31, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says, فَقُولْ أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ. So then why don't you fear him? Why don't you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How do you have taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? As we've mentioned countless times, taqwa Allah azza wa jal, it means to do the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and avoid his prohibitions. And so we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. And a last point I want to mention, ahabatifillah, is what we also see here is that this ayah, in fact, is an evidence to show that Tawheed al-Rububiyyah yastalzimu Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah. What means that the Lordship of Allah, it necessitates that you worship Him and Him alone. Meaning the next logical step, the next, what this requires from the one who acknowledges that there's only one God worthy of worship, is that they then take the next step and begin to worship Him and Him alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد